Well, after starting this little series yesterday, today is the day we finish it. My full 32 team power rankings. Today we're going to be going over the top half of teams. Teams ranked 16 to ranked 1. So let's go ahead and dive right into this as we have a lot to cover. So at number 16, we have the Minnesota Vikings down 8 spots from last year as this team really did struggle. Now we get they had a lot of quarterback injuries and a lot of big injuries in big areas. You know, Kirk Cousins was gone for the majority of the year. Justin Jefferson was in and out. But at the same time, when we look at sheer numbers and the sheer performance of this team, they had talent on that team to work with. Now, I know we didn't have a quarterback, but there is also uncertainty if Kirk Cousins comes back. I know he wants to, but will it work out from a contractual standpoint? That is yet to be determined. So with there being as much uncertainty as there is, I feel like it's safe to put the Vikings right about the middle of the pack. So, you know, this offseason could really raise them up, but I just feel like think right now they're middle of the pack. At number 15, we have the New York Jets staying put. Yes, they did have a lot of injuries, so they are in a similar boat as the Vikings, and the Vikings did, you know, play a lot better. But this team's defense has been playing well. Aaron Rodgers is going to be coming back finally now, and they're not going to be held back by poor quarterback play. We know Rodgers is coming back. He's already said that he's going to come back. And I really feel like once Rodgers gets in this team, they go up to the next level and this offense starts clicking. They're not going to be crazy, crazy good, but they're going to be a very tough team to beat next year. At number 14, we have the Jacksonville Jaguars falling a whopping 8 spots this year as they just sucked. They flat out sucked, they struggled, they could not maintain any sort of momentum they had. They collapsed down the stretch, and this team just fell flat. They have a lot of potential, but they are not living up to that potential, and that is what we need to see for a team to really be placing a high in these end-of-season power rankings. At number 13, we have the biggest risers on these lists, the Los Angeles Rams. I know people might be saying favoritism, but I really feel like this team was one of the more improved teams of the season. Going into the regular season, this team really didn't feel great. Actually, they aren't the highest risers. I just realized there's one team that rose more than them, but I think it's pretty obvious. But either way, the Rams were among the highest risers as this team was expected to really struggle and suck. They had a huge couple of diamonds in the rough this year. They had a case, somewhat of a case for Offensive Rookie of the Year, not really a strong one when CJ Stroud exists, but a solid enough case for Defensive Player of the Year as well for on the rookie side of the awards. So this team really played well. They started playing a lot better. The offensive line started working a lot more well together during the last stretch. This team ultimately really seemed like they turned gears and did not quite a rebuild, but a retooling at certain positions to allow this team to get right back up to speed in 2 years' time. At number 12, we have the Cincinnati Bengals. They are missing out on the top 10 as they did not make the playoffs this year. Now, they are still a solid team, but there's also a lot of key free agents that this team has. A lot of their receivers are going to be on contract extensions this year. And pairing that with the fact that Joe Burrow is coming back as one of the highest paid quarterbacks in the league, it is going to be really tough to be hammering out a deal with all of these wide receivers to bring everyone back. So Joe Burrow is probably going to have a little bit of a hit taken to his receiving core for 2024. At number 11, we have the Dallas Cowboys falling just one spot. They probably had an argument to fall more just because of the fact that, you know, they got blown out by the Packers. But overall, I feel like this team is finally starting to make some right steps. Yes, you did lose Dan Quinn to head coaching, but Jerry Jones did say that he is non-committal on Dak's future. So Dak is going to be in yet another prove-it deal. He can't have 10 interceptions, so he's going to be playing knowing that, hey, if I don't throw 10 picks, I'm looking at a really good spot of being on this team next year. So I really feel like the Cowboys are making those right steps. They do have a solid defense. They just had a bad game, I think, against the Packers. Overall, I feel like, though, this team is among the better teams in the league. And now we enter the top 10 with the Cleveland Browns rising 10 spots as this team did finally start to look better. The quarterback play stepped up with Joe Flacco. Will we have a Deshaun Watson play to that level? I'm not 100% sure. But even if he plays to half the level of Flacco, this team should be solid, especially since we have the younger quarterback in Deshaun Watson in Cleveland. So there is a lot more time for the Browns to get something going. There is a sense of urgency that things need to happen sooner rather than later. But it's not a basically win the Super Bowl or bust kind of year for the Browns. At number 9, we have the Miami Dolphins staying put from last year as this team really has been alright. I mean, they play well against bad teams. They play down against good teams. They're really kind of a meh team right now, and I feel like just considering where these other teams have placed, I feel like they have the potential to beat any of these teams. They're just not living up to that potential. McDaniel is going to be on a hot seat this year and making sure that he needs to get stuff done. So I really feel like he does have a chance at taking this team to the next level. But right now, I'm just not 100% sold on him yet. At number 8, speaking of a team I'm not 100% sold on, we have the Philadelphia Eagles falling a whopping 6 spots from last year. They probably could have fallen more, but overall, I feel like this team just really has the potential. They're just not living up to it. They are making a few big changes. They're making a few changes at the coordinator position. Both coordinators are getting changed this offseason for the Eagles, so that could really make a difference in that Eagles defense. Next year, it could make a difference in their offense next year as well. So I'm looking forward to seeing what this team can do. They do have a lot of potential still. Yes, Jason Kelce retired, but you should be able to find some other center out there. And overall, you do have a very mobile quarterback who is great at eluding those sacks in Jalen Hurts. At number 7, we have the Green Bay Packers, because, man, this team is back. After getting rid of Aaron Rodgers, they are back quick. This team started playing up really well. I feel like defensively, they have a lot of the good pieces. They just needed to have a better coordinator. So with Joe Barry out the door, you open that up for a good coordinator to come in and make something happen with this Packers team. Pairing that with the fact that Jordan Love had a really good first season under center, this Packers team just has nowhere to go but up for the next few years. At number 6, we have the Buffalo Bills. This team is staying put from last season because, well, they did about what we expected. They made the playoffs, they blew it in the playoffs, but they still have the talent. So they finally made the change at offensive coordinator this season, which really does help their case from falling. And I really feel like this team has the potential to do something good. Once again, a lot of these teams, they have the potential. The NFL is a league of parity anymore, so it's tough to say this team is definitively the best. But I really feel like they have the potential to be that best team if they can live up to that potential. At number 5, we have the biggest rise I have ever seen in any power rankings at any time at any point in history. The Houston Texans rising a whopping 25 spots from year to year. Because, man, this team just turned it around. They got the 2nd and 3rd overall pick to draft both the offensive and defensive rookie of the year. And that defense started playing really well down the stretch under DeMeco Ryans. CJ Stroud just doing whatever CJ Stroud does to win games. This team is in a great spot. They have a bright future ahead of them. And overall, this team really does feel like a team that you should be scared of in the NFL for the next 5, 10, 15 years. At number 4, we have the Detroit Lions increase in 3 spots because they played pretty well. They have the potential. I mean, they had a very good shot at winning the NFC Championship game and going to the Super Bowl. But alas, they failed to do so. They kind of done themselves in on a couple of bad gambles they lost. So overall, this team does feel like they have the potential to go further. I feel like this year was a year of growth for this team. They learned what they can and can't get away with. They learned how to play it well as a team, and they learned how to get to those big games. So I really feel like this team rising 3 spots is a fair enough move. At number 3, we have another big riser, the Baltimore Ravens. I was not very high on the Ravens. I was like, yeah, they'll be solid, but they're not going to be anything too special going into last year. They proved me wrong. They played some really, really, really good football. And man, this team really looks like the cream of the crop in the AFC for the regular season. Playoffs, it's got to go to Patrick Mahomes. But regular season, oh boy, I just broke my pencil. But regular season, it's got to go to Lamar Jackson and the Ravens. At number 2, we have the San Francisco 49ers rising 3 spots because, well, they did play a lot better. They made some better trades to get in Chase Young. Yes, he's a free agent, but I think they make it work with him. And overall, you have a really good roster with this team that is being led by a decent quarterback. So that is obviously going to get you far. It's going to get you anywhere you want to go. And really just seeing how much Brock Purdy was able to grow this year and grow around this team just shows that this team is just growing every single day. Now, number 1, you know him, you hate him, the Kansas City Chiefs. Taylor Swift and the Chiefs ended up getting number 1 because, well, you can't do any better than winning a Super Bowl now, can ya? It was a great game back and forth, but overall, the Chiefs just feel like this team can just do whatever they want and win. Especially now they're more dangerous at the fact that Patrick Mahomes is looking to restructure his deal to get on a Brady-style contract so that the Chiefs can bring in and retain more high-end talent for him to throw the ball to. Like, oh my god, this team's going to be even scarier next year. So obviously they're taking the number 1 spot. Alright, well that's about going to do it for me today. If you guys did like, don't forget to smash like and subscribe as it does help me out a whole lot. And also make sure you go ahead and check out the video that's popping up down here. It is going to be my first part of the series, teams ranked 32 to 17. So if you missed that, there's a good chance to check up and catch up on that. And I guess with that, I will see you guys later. Peace out and have a good one.